Hello and welcome to the 24's first concert of the academic year. What a strange thing that is to be saying, but actually quite normal for these days. We have had a year. We've been rehearsing as best we can. We were able to sing together, separated, masked in the autumn term and since the beginning of this term, but our spring term was about listening to music together, singing along, and me trying to guess what errors the choir might have made and might have needed help with, rather than actually knowing, of course, in common with so many choirs. We feel very lucky to be singing at the moment, given the latest government guidance on amateur choirs, but as a student body, it's been possible for us. Our programme tonight in three parts. The last bit is the Finzi, Lo, the Full Final Sacrifice, which was suggested by one of the students, actually. It's almost a sort of comfort food, such a wonderful piece of writing and something quite familiar to choral singers. And then to start the concert, the double choir mass by Franck Martin, written 99 years ago. There were always 1 year ahead in the 24. It'll be celebrated next year, no doubt. But we've got in there first. Lovely double choir piece. With Renaissance antecedents, you can tell from the part writing and the sheer joy in writing an a cappella mass. And it's a precious piece of music, really, because there isn't as much a cappella writing for choir in the early part of the 20th century as one might like. The orchestra was the main compositional means that composers used, and so to find such a beautifully written piece is wonderful. Interesting that some of the choir had sung it before, but I never had, so a new one for me. And in between those, we're going to hear three one-to-a-part groups, master's group and two undergraduate groups, who are preparing for recitals, and we thought we'd use this as an opportunity to give them some performance practice, nothing like real live performance practice. And so they're going to sing works by Gesualdo Monteverdi and Anders Edenroth, the director of the, not the director, one of the writers and singers in the real group. But to start with, the whole of the Mass by Franck Martin. Thanks for watching.
Thank you. this part of the concert, we have three solo voice ensemble items, this one by a second year group, and they're singing a madrigal by Carlo Gesualdo, Prince of Venosa, who wrote very harmonically advanced music. And this is just about the only piece that celebrates joy, at least it does for about the first six bars, and then it goes into Gesualdo's usual extreme lamenting and some quite strange twists of harmony.
Joy.
The second piece is sung by the MA Solo Voice Ensemble, and they're singing a piece by Monteverdi from the opening of his fourth book of madrigals in 1603. His last book of entirely unaccompanied pieces, and for me it really sums up what they were about in the Renaissance, which is part writing, but also the visceral use of vocal harmony. And the text is, "Ah, dolente partita, ah, painful parting, must I leave you and yet not die."
Thank you.
our third group, the third year solo voice ensemble singing group, and they've chosen a piece by Anders Edenroth from the real group called Words.
One, two, three.
Words, a letter and a letter on a string will hold forever humanity's spellbound words, possession of the beggar and the king. Everybody, every day, you and I, we often say words, regarded as a complicated tool, created by man, implicated by mankind. Words, obsession of the genius and the fool. Everybody, every day, everywhere and every way, oh, words, find them, you can use them, say them, you can hear them, write them, you can read them, love them, fear them. Words transmitted as we feared from the start, received by all, and we are sentenced to a life with words, impression on the stupid and the smart. Everybody, every day, you and I, we often say words inside your head. Come alive as the said softly, loudly, modestly, and proudly. Words, expression by the living and the dead. Everybody, every day, everywhere, and every way. Oh, words, find them, you can use them, say them, you can hear them, write.
Final work in the programme is Gerald Finzi's Lo, the Full Final Sacrifice, which he wrote for the Reverend Walter Hussey, the vicar of a church in Northampton, which may sound just like any other church, except Walter Hussey commissioned an enormous amount of choral music during his active life. This is from just after the Second World War, 21st of September 1946, it's marked. And it's a confluence of two different poems. It's unmistakably Finzi. As soon as you get into bar two, you start hearing those seventh chords, and it sounds like Finzi. It's a piece that's sort of iconic in the English choral tradition. Quite a lot of the choir, when I asked, had sung it before. We only decided quite late in the day to do this piece. It's a sort of comfort food for us, because it's such a part of the English choral tradition. And I've asked an English student singing in the choir, Cordelia Hobbs, just to say a word about the poetry, because I've sung this piece, I reckon, about four times, and at no stage did anyone try to explain what the poem was about. And it's about the communion service in the Christian church. So, Cordelia.
The text of Finzi's Lo, the Full Final Sacrifice is a medley of two poems by Richard Crashaw. It's primarily a celebration of the Eucharist, as Robert said, in particular the act of communion, of taking bread and wine as the blood and body of Christ. Creshaw is interested in the duality and the juxtaposition of this act. Communion reminds Christians of Jesus' death and that it gives them life, entrance to heaven, and absolution of their sins. Creshaw was a poet of the metaphysical tradition. Meta literally means in Greek beyond, so here we're talking about beyond the physical. So we're dealing with these vast and wondrous metaphors that have the uncanny ability to be able to remove themselves from space and time, kind of like the equivalent of 17th century sci-fi. So through using metaphysical ideas, Creshaw creates different spaces. The opening, for example, is somber, solemn, and heavy. Other moments are huge declamations of joy and devotion that swiftly turn into withdrawn, intimate lamentations. I hope our performance of the piece helps you reach these spaces, and I hope you enjoy it.